cutting our toxic load. Every day we lose large chunks of earth trampled and loosened by overgrazing cattle, sheep, and pigs, and blown or washed out to sea. This amounts to a net loss of about 1,000 acres of topsoil per year. Iowa has lost half of its fertile topsoil over the past century and is continuing to lose topsoil at an alarming rate. When our natural resource base deteriorates as a result of topsoil depletion and pollution of our groundwater, we pass on a weakened capacity for future generations to prosper and enjoy good health. Consider the decline of ancient civilizations in Mesopotamia, the Mediterranean region, pre-Columbian Southwest U.S., and Central America. Historians believe that these cultures disappeared into vapor because of their failure to make a successful transition from subsistence farming to an agricultural economy robust enough to support large populations. To help preserve our farmland, we could alter our diet and become healthier by eating more of a plant-based organic diet. Vegetarianism involves a highly rewarding lifestyle that fosters respect for oneself and other animals. Not eating the flesh of dead animals gives us a longer lifespan, decreases chronic diseases, and improves our ability to control our weight. Vegetarian or not, we would all be better off if we stopped eating so much meat. At the very least, we should avoid animal fats because of the real possibility that they are laden with deadly bacteria and too much dioxin. Toxic chemicals such as dioxin affect our farm-raised animals as well as our wildlife. Fortunately, toxic residues are not readily incorporated into many fruits, vegetables, cereal grains, or other plant materials if they are present in the soil or sprayed on the growing plant. Many pesticide residues can be washed off or peeled off in the outer leaves of plants or the skin of fruit. Toxic substances in meat are embedded into the cells of the meat tissue and cannot be removed. We should never eat the brains of any animal and should avoid all organ meats because these are the body parts most likely to be contaminated with toxins from the environment, as well as brain proteins called prions, which can reproduce themselves and can cause mad cow disease. Of course, we can't avoid all exposure to environmental toxins in the food chain and in our water and air. But by modifying our food choices, we can reduce the toxic load on our bodies by almost 50%. Recommendations for healthy living. I'm going to share with you 7 simple recommendations that will make it easier for you to follow a vegetarian or Asian Mediterranean type diet. We would all be healthier by substituting meat with soy, consuming eggs only from free-range chickens, if at all, insisting on low-fat dairy products from organically fed cows, and focusing on soy, tofu, seeds, and nuts. Here are my recommendations. First, avoid animal fats. Most types of meat, but especially organ meat, as well as eggs, milk, cheese, and margarine, are high in saturated animal fats. Most of these foods are also contaminated with toxic amounts of environmental or xenoestrogens. If you must eat meat, use organic chicken without the skin and avoid farmed fish. Remove the skin and cook all fresh fish thoroughly, baking, poaching, and broiling as best. Better yet, eat soybean products such as tofu, veggie burgers, and tempeh instead. John Robbins' books on alternative diets will give you more details on this subject. Second, eat more fresh fruits, vegetables, and seed oils. These colorful foods are your best source for vitamins and other nutrients essential for good health. Fruits and vegetables do not contain fat or processed sugar. Choose healthier fats, such as flaxseed, safflower, sunflower seed, peanut, walnut, avocado, pumpkin seed, sesame seed, and grapeseed oils. Most seeds and nuts are also healthy options for high-quality proteins and make delicious additions to salads, snacks, and baked goods. Lentils, soybeans, and fat-free refried beans are great protein sources. Third, do not use plastic containers and plastic wraps for storing food. The toxins in plastic can leach into the food you are trying to protect. Be safe and replace plastic with wax paper or glass jars. Use ceramic dishes only for serving or heating food. Never microwave food in plastic containers. Fourth, ask your doctor to test your hormone levels. If your levels test low in serum or salivary testing, request a prescription for the deficient hormone. Remind the doctor to test for free hormone levels, as well as total and protein-bound hormone levels. Fifth, stay away from saturated fats and trans fats. Avoid all fried foods, refined sugars, and corn syrup or diet foods, as they contain chemicals associated with an increasing risk of cancer. Commercial products such as trans fatty acid-free Smart Balance, a buttery spread sold in supermarkets and health food stores across the country, are great sources of healthy, unsaturated fats. To avoid contamination from mercury, avoid and cut back on eating fish from the Great Lakes and all farmed salmon. Nordic Naturals in Watsonville, California, is one company that removes all the mercury as well as the fishy taste from their fish oil capsules. Fish oil capsules have been found to contain much less dioxin and PCBs than the corresponding fish. For those deep-fried snacks that you love, make sure they're made with olestra, an indigestible fat substitute which may help to eliminate dioxin. Sixth, elevate your mood by eating more foods that encourage production of serotonin in your brain. Bananas, tomatoes, plums, avocados, pineapples, eggplant, walnuts, and dates and figs are high in compounds known as serotonin precursors. These compounds do not directly produce serotonin, but make it easier for your brain to manufacture and release this natural, mood-elevating hormone into your bloodstream. And seventh, eat more natural foods rich in healthful minerals. Increase your intake of minerals such as selenium, zinc, calcium, magnesium, iron, and copper by eating more fresh fruit, vegetables, seeds, and nuts. Incorporate one antioxidant supplement, pycnogenol, quercetin, ginger, or garlic, into your daily diet to reduce the toxicity from dioxins, PCBs, and phthalates, and other toxic compounds. You'll also want to eat more bioflavonoids, bioactive antioxidants found in Juice Plus, and vitamins K, A, C, E, D, ubiquitone, or CoQ10, and folic acid. Lycopenes are antioxidants found in watermelon, grapes, tomatoes, and some shellfish. Lycopenes are only released by cooking the food. They seem to help to treat dioxin-induced infertility in men. Lycopenes are one class of the 650 carotenoids found in high concentrations in the testicles of normal males and in low levels in infertile males. Physicians are studying the use of lycopenes as a nutrient useful in preventing prostate cancer. Hope is alive that one day we can clean up our environment and produce a safe food supply for the American people without the presence of toxins destructive to our endocrine system, such as PCBs, PVCs, TCDDs, and dioxin. Until that time, if you want good health, you should modify your food choices and focus on a plant-based diet with an intelligent selection of supplements of bioflavonoids, antioxidants, and vegetable oils free from trans fatty acids. Again, if you must eat fried foods, try those made with olestra. Each person is a powerful force for change. We should make a noble effort to save our planet for our children. If someone becomes a vegetarian, awareness of this lifestyle choice can help to stop the senseless slaughter of animals, and one small change can help to decrease the ongoing pollution of our world.